A lot of audiophiles don't like tone control, and after working on the Galion project, yeah, I can understand why. For example, from a measurement perspective, when you engage tone control and feed the amp with a square wave, it cannot reproduce the square wave properly. For many audiophiles, there is a loss in fidelity when using tone control. Also, tone control can also introduce phase issues. I've actually experienced this problem where the soundstage feels a bit off when tone control was engaged. The other problem of tone control is when you drop the treble, for example, just the treble, okay? It can sound like there's a veil in front of your speakers. You not only get a muddy sounding mid-range, you also lose all the detail, the sparkling top end. Now, I understand some of us are forced to use tone control to combat listening fatigue, despite it sound like crap. Now, so let's talk about my journey with voicing the tone control on the TS-120. The reason why I insisted on having tone control on the TS-120 is that for me, the 5% loss in fidelity is worth it. I'd rather have that than get listening fatigue. When you use sound profile T on the TS-120, this is the part where it engages tone control. The other sound profile will bypass tone control. Now, the tone control on the TS-120 only affects about 3 to 4 dB either way. Some of you might be wondering, why? Most tone control affects 8 dB. Look, man, if you have to use tone control to affect 8 dB, you bought the wrong amplifier. This is not an AVR amp. This is high-end audio where everything is about precision. You buy the TS-120 because the sound is what you're looking for. Tone control is just for that minor adjustment, if needed. As such, I was okay when they told me, look, man, your tone control is going to be only affecting 3 to 4 dB. Because my goal was to build a tone control that does not sound like a tone control. Usually when you talk about tone control, the treble part, okay, it affects the 10 kilohertz region, like my Luxman SQN150 here, for example. For me, my goal is to build a tone control that deals with listening fatigue. And for me, it's usually in the shouty voice area the problem. I do not want a tone control that sounds veiled. I want to preserve all the sparkling top end, just kill the part where that causes sibilance. As such, I had to have many samples built for me, the tone control part, one affecting 10 kilohertz, 8 kilohertz, 7 kilohertz, and so forth. What I realized is some tone control affects the phase, and some give that veiled sounding feeling, but when you get it right, it just affects the vocal. The top end sparkling is not affected, neither the sound stage. So when engaging tone control with the treble set to the minimum on the TS-120, yes, it'll sound a bit veiled compared to when you don't turn on tone control, but after one song, it's just going to be like normal because the top end sparkling part is preserved. For those of you who like smooth sounding amps, this will impress you. Basically, it achieved that musical setting I originally intended. I personally really like it. In fact, the other day, Mr. Carver heard it for the first time on the normal edition. He confirmed with me that, yeah, you don't lose the sparkling top end, but rather just that sibilance part where the upper mid-range is. Because the special edition is smoother sounding already, I personally find tone control more useful on the normal edition. With the special edition, hey man, you probably might even turn up tone control to get some bite. Now, as you can see, even tone control, I have to spend a lot of time on it because I really wanted the TS-120 to kick ass. So I want to end the video by talking about the musical and analytical setting that I originally wanted. The Galion TS-120 had three sound profiles. Originally, I had musical, tone, and analytical. However, due to the changes of voicing in both the TS-120 and the improvement in tone control, I removed the musical and analytical setting and finally settled on sound profile A, B, and T. Just a reminder, T stands for tone control. The difference in sound between A and B is only 3%. Originally, my goal was to make it 10%, but because right now the Galion is voiced to be smoother, and most importantly, I can achieve that musical setting even better with this tone control, I've decided to make this big change. Profile A is the one that measures good, slightly sharper, while profile B measures not as good, but slightly more smoother. If I were to implement the musical and analytical profile like I originally intended, both would have not measured good. Given the upgraded tone control is able to achieve even better results than what I originally planned for the musical setting, I decided to remove it. Okay, guys, till next time.